हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू ज्योग्राफी क्लास फॉर लेसन नंबर 5, नेचुरल वेजिटेशन एंड वाइल्ड लाइफ। स्टूडेंट्स, वी हैव ऑलरेडी लर्न अबाउट द नेचुरल वेजिटेशन ऑफ इंडिया एज वेल एज ब्राज़ील। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द न्यू टॉपिक ऑफ दिस लेसन, दैट इज वाइल्ड लाइफ ऑफ ब्राज़ील। हियर यू आर गिवन विथ वन एक्टिविटी बेस्ड ऑन मैप। Here the map of Brazil is given with an index which indicates the forest and wildlife of Brazil. Here the types of forest are given, and according to that various color tints are given to you. The category is like this: equatorial forests, tropical grasslands, swampy lands, hot deciduous forest, thorny shrubs and temperate grassland. According to the distribution of forest land, different types of wild animals are found here. So here you just need to observe the map and give the questions given here. So on the basis of figure 5.4, answer the following questions. First, name the species shown on the map. Condor, anaconda, golden lion, tamarin, macaw, etc. Here if you will observe, so you can see that these are the different types of animals which are shown here in the map of Brazil. They are condor, anaconda, golden lion, tamarin, macaw, etc. Okay. Next, here, in which regions are these animals found? Why are their habitats found in these forests? That means, कौन से रीजन में ये एनिमल्स मोस्टली हमें मिलते हैं, वेयर दे आर एक्चुअली एग्जिस्टिंग और फाउंड, एंड वट इज़ द रीज़न बिहाइंड देर दैट देर हैबिटेट इज़ फाउंड इन दिस फॉरेस्ट एरिया ओनली। सो गोल्डन लायन, टेमेरिन, कॉन्डर, स्क्वेरिल एंड कुकेटू आर फाउंड इन द इक्वेटोरियल फॉरेस्ट रीजन। यू विल सी दैट इक्वेटोरियल फॉरेस्ट रीजन विद अ ग्रीन कलर, डार्क ग्रीन कलर। Okay, similarly anaconda and other reptiles are found here. This is because these forests lie near the Amazon river basin. Also, the equator passes through the northern part of the country and it receives heavy rainfall, that is throughout the year, and hence the climate is hot and humid. These conditions are not only favorable for the growth of vegetation, but also animals like birds and reptiles can best survive in it. As I told you earlier that equator is passing through the northern side of Brazil, and as this part or northern part of Brazil receives more heat from the sun as when the temperature is rises, so therefore this leads to the more evaporation, more moistures are formed, so it leads to a heavy rainfall. And because of this, throughout the year we can experience rainfall here, and the climate is also here hot and humid type, so that it is best place for the survival of vegetation as well as for animals. If we will see about the next category of the animals, that is macaw and green-headed tanagers are found in the tropical grassland, while crocodile and other reptiles inhabit in the swampy lands. Swampy, that means बहुत ज़्यादा जो है water जब percolate हो जाता है तो एक जो पूरा दलदल जैसा form हो जाता है उसे कहते हैं swampy area. So there you can find the reptile like crocodiles. Macaw is a parrot and it eats a variety of foods including seeds, nuts, palm fruits, leaves, flowers and stems. This is easily available in tropical grassland region, and it is also found near the river Tocantins and near the Amazon river basin. Similarly, green-headed tanager eats fruit and insects. These insects are easily available on the grasses, while the crocodile find the swampy land favorable for the habitation. If you will observe, so you can understand students that here, according to the ecosystem, that means the places where these animals can survive easily, according to that their habitat is also divided. Next one, in the coastal regions of Brazil, flamingos are found because fish in there is their main food. The southeastern coastal region of Brazil is favorable for the growth of fish. The main reason is that the warm Brazil current and the cold Falkland current meet off the coast of southeast Brazil. Therefore, this coastal region is the main habitat for flamingos. If you will remember, आपको अगर याद होगा सो यू हैव ऑलरेडी लर्न इन द स्मॉलर स्टैंडर्ड्स दैट दिस ओशनिक करंट्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट इन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू ऑफ दिस फिशिंग ग्राउंड्स और द फॉर फिशिंग एज द प्लेसेस वेयर कोल्ड करंट मीट्स द वॉर्म करंट दीज प्लेसेस आर द प्लेसेस वेयर फिशिंग इज इजीली कैरिंग ऑन बिकॉज the place where cold and warm current meets there is those places are very good for the growth of plankton and plankton is a fish for food sorry food for fishes and therefore mostly we can find that mostly these fishes breed over there at the places where warm and cold current meets and therefore we can find flamingos also here because fishes is the food of flamingos so mostly in coastal region of Brazil we can find flamingos too here next question classify the forest region with reference to their extent that means forest region ka classification kaisa hai so with reference to their extent The equatorial forest cover the maximum part of Brazil. You can see equatorial forest जो है वो पूरा mostly green जो है dark green part जो है वो पूरा Amazon River basin का it is what equatorial forest. It is what maximum part is covered by this forest area and it is followed by tropical grassland. और उसके अलावा जो ज़्यादातर cover part है वो कौन सा है ट्रॉपिकल ग्रास लैंड का सम पार्ट इज हैविंग द थॉर्नी श्रब्स and temperate grassland but most of the part is covered by equatorial forest and tropical grasslands here students you are given with one more column colors of both here also questions as answers are given in which country do equatorial forest occupy a greater area what could be the reason behind it in Brazil equatorial forest occupies greater area the reason is that The equator passes through northern part of the Brazil hence the climate is generally hot throughout the year moreover this region receives heavy rainfall throughout the year the rainfall is mostly convectional type of rainfall as I told you earlier that equator is passing through the northern part of Brazil so it receives heat from the sun throughout the year and even here you can find the rainy season or the rainfall whole of the year mostly you can find convectional type of rainfall here so that we can see there say that here climate will be hot and humid next which type of forest found in India are not found in Brazil that means aise forest jo India mein hai lekin is type ke forest jo Brazil mein nahi hote hain the evergreen forest deciduous forest and thorny shrubs type vegetation which are found in Brazil are also found in India which type of forest found in India are not found in Brazil so here thorny shrubs are mostly found in India but these are very less in Brazil which type of forest found in Brazil are found in India too so we can say that the evergreen forest deciduous forest and thorny shrub types of vegetation which are found in Brazil are also found in India here some mistake is actually thodi si mistake ho gayi hai slide banane mein so same answer repeat ho gaya but actually the main answer is that if ye puchta hai ki vegetation jo hai jo India mein hai lekin Brazil mein nahi hoti hai to mostly thorny shrub jo hai wo coastal areas ke jo hai wo इंडिया में है बट ब्राज़ील में नहीं होते हैं एंड हियर विच टाइप ऑफ फॉरेस्ट फाउंड इन ब्राज़ील एंड फाउंड इन इंडिया टू सो डेसीडियस एवरग्रीन फॉरेस्ट एंड थॉर्नी श्रब टाइप फॉरेस्ट आर फाउंड इन इंडिया एज वेल एज इन ब्राज़ील टू इन विच कंट्री अ ग्रेटर डाइवर्सिटी ऑफ वेजिटेशन इज फाउंड वॉट इज द रीज़न बिहाइंड इट So in Brazil, greater diversity vegetation is found. The reason behind it is that because of the equatorial type of climate, sufficient water, ample of sunlight and heavy rainfall. So it gives a favorable condition so that we can find our diversity in the vegetation here. Considering the climate and vegetation types, in which country will forest-based occupation flourish? That means if you will consider the climate and vegetation and types of forest, so which type of occupation mostly flourish? Forest-based occupation jo hai wo zyada kaun se country mein flourished hai? So considering the climate and vegetation type, vegetation type, forest-based occupation would flourish in Brazil. Because Brazil jo ek aisa place hai where you can find the diversity in vegetation too. Now, here you are given with some explanation, students, related to the wildlife. A greater diversity in wildlife is found in Brazil than any other country in the world. In the swampy areas of the Pantanal, huge anacondas are found. Anaconda, you know, na? Snakes jo hote hain, bade bade se jo hote hain, jo bahut zyada zehreele hote hain. Those are known as anaconda. Mostly you can find them at the places of the Pantanal. In Brazil, guiana pig, crocodile, alligators, monkeys, pumas and leopards etc. are found. See, here pictures are shown to you so that you can understand it better. Here, see, alligator and crocodile both are different. Jo center mein hai wo kya hai? Crocodile hai. And jo crocodile ke bilkul niche hai, beneath to the this crocodile, that is what alligator. Both are very different. See, you can find these variety of animals here. Even among the fish varieties, mainly swordfish are found in the sea, while pink dolphin and piranhas are found in the river. See, this is pink dolphin. Next to pink dolphin is a piranhas, and upper side there is a pick of this swordfish. Okay, condors, which are huge in size, are fly high in the sky. See, this is condors, they fly high in the sky. These are also found here in Brazil. And even various types of the parrots, macaws and flamingos are major birds found here. These are the diversities found in the birds here. Millions of the insects varieties are also found here. As a result, these varieties, the wildlife of Brazil is very rich and diverse. You can see that so many type of animals, birds, reptiles, all are found here. So we can say that Brazil is very rich and diverse. Degradation of environment is happening due to illegal smuggling of wild animals. आपने देखा होगा tortoise वगैरह जो होते हैं उनकी illegal smuggling होती है. So mostly because of this, degradation of environment is happening, and even slash and burn of agriculture, that is what known as roca, deforestation, pollution, etc. Brazil is facing these problems today. Many academic species are on the very on the verge of getting extinct because of these issues. See, all these are the component or factor which leads to the environment degradation actually. And because of this, we can see that there is a extinct in the varieties of the animals also in Brazil. कुछ ऐसे एनिमल्स जो पहले पाए जाते थे, बट अब क्या हो गया, उनकी स्पेसिस कम होते होते बिल्कुल खत्म होने आई है. द रीज़न बिहाइंड इज दैट द प्लेसेस होते द हैबिटेट ऑफ द एनिमल्स दे वर जस्ट फेसिंग द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ दिस डिफॉरेस्टेशन, डिग्रेडेशन ऑफ एनवायरनमेंट, बर्न एग्रीकल्चर, पॉल्यूशन एक्सेट्रा. सो जो उनका रहने का प्लेस है वही क्या हो रहा है, डिस्ट्रॉय हो रहा है. सो वेयर दे विल गो, सो फाइनली देयर स्पेसिस गोइंग टू बी एक्सटिंक्ट. सो इट इज़ अ नीड ऑफ टाइम टू जस्ट सेव दिस स्पेसिस सो दैट इट विल बी our heritage and it will be useful for our future generations too. So we must take care of environment and we must protect the environment from degradation. So students, here we completed the wildlife of Brazil. In the coming video, we will be going to learn about India wildlife. And so that you can, while you are learning about the wildlife of India, so that you can understand it more clearly, that what is the similarity and dissimilarity between India and Brazil regarding their wildlife too. Thank you, students.